Hi, I'm Ivan Zoot with Jatai Academy. Welcome to another educational video in our series. Today we're answering a viewer slash reader question. And the question was, can you really explain to me a little bit about the difference between wet versus dry razor cutting when we're hair cutting? And I think it's a fabulous question because there's a lot of misinformation, sometimes on the part of our clients and sometimes even on the part of hair cutters, about the impact of the razor as we use it to cut hair. As a general rule, my suggestion would be that on most textures of hair, if we are sculpting full haircuts, if we're doing significant hair cutting, I would want to be cutting on wet hair. Wet hair will allow for better slip and slide. You know, the Blade Glide Plus from Jatai is a fabulous product for lubricating the hair, for maintaining even and consistent moisture and hydration. Inconsistencies in hydration or moisture in the hair will lead to inconsistencies in tension and distribution. It's harder to get precision haircuts on dry hair cutting when it comes to razor cutting. Now, there's a lot of passion in our industry today for dry hair cutting with scissors, and I understand the argument is we're gonna cut the hair like they wear the hair. You're gonna wear your hair dry, we're gonna cut it dry. And there also is room for conversation about dry hair cutting with razors. And the two kind of parameters I would put on it are, number one, I wouldn't really be doing full haircuts. If I really am concerned with balance and symmetry and distribution, sectioning and tension, hydrated hair that is evenly and consistently wet to damp makes more sense. That being said, on dry hair, two things. Number one, a very, very sharp, a brand new blade, so that I've got a really, really good edge to work with. And number two, I would limit my dry razor hair cutting to creative texturizing and detailing. If I'm breaking up a fringe, if I'm adding softness to sides of a haircut, if I'm wisping up a neckline, what a great opportunity to come in with our razor and just the tip of the razor or our razor texturizing, our specialty feather texturizing blade, what a great opportunity for detailing and working dry. There will be an issue of client comfort if you're doing a lot of heavy cutting. In the interest of client comfort, again, I think we're better off cutting with wet hair. That being said, working with a very, very dry, with very, very sharp blade and working only in a detailing mode, I think dry razor cutting gives us an incredible amount of opportunity for creativity and flexibility. Full haircuts, sometimes I want a blade that's got a little mileage, a little less edge to it, but I'll always want to be working with wet to damp hair. I'm Ivan Zoot for Jatai Academy. I look forward to hearing how you experiment with wet and dry razor cutting with both the traditional feather razor blade as well as the feather texturizing blade. There's a world of possibilities available to you, and we're excited to see what you can create. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.